It's great speaking with you today, Ankit. This is going to be an interesting topic today about strategies for superior results through supply chain. My first question is, can you first provide a brief background of yourself?
Yeah. Hi, Dustin. Thank you for having me here. This is Ankit Khullar from Fluor India. I've been working in supply chain management for the past 4.5 years. I started with telecom industry, then moved on to mining and metals, and now majorly I'm working in oil and gas. After serving those four industries, I'm in a position to generalize that supply chain can affect a major part of your strategy. And till late 20th century, generally we saw supply chain only as a buying and negotiation part. But now in 21st century, executives and higher management eyeballs are focusing on supply chain for cost reduction and improvement. Thank you.
Thanks. Can you talk about some of the important strategies that are for getting superior results through supply chain?
Yeah, I mean, like, leading organizations are continuing to incorporate best supply chain practices into their operations. Executives agreed that declining commodity prices and contracting availability of capital for new projects is not over, and recover from this slowdown will be slow and painful. Optimism for green shoots is premature at this stage, and the precipitous fall in the prices of oil has caused governments all over the world and international companies to review the investment and risk assessment for 2015 and beyond. Generally, what happened is business units are expecting immediate prices concessions from supplier based on the collapse in the prices in the market. But supply market softness does not necessarily mean that even supplier costs align with peak softness. So price reduction may not be as readily available as imagined by business unit leaders. So it is important to draft some short-term and long-term supply chain strategies to meet business unit expectations. Like, there must be a balanced approach between short-term and long-term strategic supply objectives. As per a recent report, 85% of the companies have a rigorous cost reduction program, and only 8% meet their target because the program is based either on short-term or long-term objectives. So supply strategies basically fall into two categories. As I told you, it must be a balanced approach between short-term cost improvement and long-term strategic supply objective. Like, if we talk about short-term cost improvements through supply chain, that must include quickly reduction in the supplier prices, especially through, let's suppose, if commodity prices, we know that in upcoming week or so, commodity prices will decline. So you can draft strategies accordingly. And short-term price reductions are basically based on opportunities with raw material and orthodox strategies of contract recovery, renegotiation. And let's suppose if right now most of the world is moving towards Asia-Pacific for manufacturing, like if we are buying any material from Europe, that must be 40% higher the value if we went to either China or India. But we need to consider the origin of material and quality checks as well. If we are getting the same quality from Asia-Pac, then I don't think so that there must be any problem in moving towards Asia-Pacific. And two long-term strategies aims at, the second part is long-term strategies. Long-term strategies must aim at achieving the best-in-class status and longer-term cost and revenue benefits. We must have some upgraded talent. We should have some integrated work progress with the suppliers. I mean, we should have some enhanced supplier relationships. We should have enhanced internal relationships. And it has been found that generally, whenever we are doing something big, it will be magnified. So if we draw some long-term strategies focusing on certain parameters, the results will be magnified. So comprehensive transformation drives large stakeholder gain. For example, let us say that companies are taking action to stabilize the supply chain, which including prices, suppliers, adjusting capacity to demand, while continuing its journey to world-class supply chain excellence. Continuing focus on enhancing talent, process, total cost, strategic sourcing, and supplier working relationship indirectly aimed at winning against the competition. So longer term initiative for cost improvement through collaborative action with a shared vision can improve cost transparency, and companies expect the magnified gain that supply chain creates. Companies are taking initiative for complexity reduction, value engineering, and sharing risk with suppliers. So I think that long-term strategies depends on different industry based on their industry experience. But these are the parameters what I told you that they need to consider. What is actual value for them? How they can improve their cost transparency, and they can get magnified results based on their supply chain long-term strategy. Yes.
And can you talk a little bit about in practice how this is done, how the strategies are done?
Yeah. Suppose if I took some general cases, let's suppose we know that cash is a king. If a company is a living machine, cash works as a spine for it. So companies need to need cash to pay their workforce and suppliers. If enough cash is not generated by the business, then company need to borrow the money to meet the cash deficit. And credit is also very expensive nowadays. So supply chain management is playing an important role in preserving cash by, let's suppose if you don't need any deliveries, and you can like delay your deliveries. So your cash management, cash flow can help you in getting stronger in the market. So there are many things like payment terms. Suppose earlier we used to have 100% 9 days payment terms for all of our operations. Now what we can do is stretching out our terms to the supplier helps the cash position of the buying company. I mean, by extending the payment terms, we shift a financial burden to the supplier as well. It is like if supplier can agree to 60 days payment term, we somehow shift our financial burden to the supplier. In 60 days, we can circulate the money and enhance the value of supply chain. So thus, companies are carefully considering payment terms and discount terms for their impact on both the buyer and their supplier. Few suppliers are coupling other earlier payment terms, like some are saying that if you will pay us as soon as delivery will be done, we will offer you a significant amount of discount. So taking advantage of early pay discounts can also make economic sense. There is also some short-term strategies, like I told you, regarding the commodity prices. Nowadays, cost models are drafted as per purchase categories and cost elements that has significant raw material content for which the raw material costs were declining at a rapid rate. But executives need to understand that a drop of 50% in the copper prices does not mean that suppliers of copper-based products can drop prices by 50% across the board. For better understanding, two companies are using third parties, some cost modeling tools to examine the raw material content elements. An analysis of raw material usage and key cost drivers can help quantify the realities for price reduction. Nowadays, one more thing we people are doing is spend analytics. We are living in the age of transformation and IT transformation. So let's suppose we have our offices in different parts of the world, like Fluor has offices in 54 different countries. So are we buying the same items across our location and pay different prices? Spread analytics can answer many questions: who, why, where, what, when, and how of organization expenditure. Spend analysis can provide valuable visibility into an organization's procurement spending, which in turn allows the organization to consolidate both its supplier and spending. So I think spend analytics can help companies achieve wonders in their operations, for example, lower procurement costs, streamlined procurement process, and efficient procurement staff.
And thanks. Do you have any final comments regarding where you've seen good results?
Yeah, I have seen good results. Like I was reading a magazine last week from IFM, this month magazine, and there was an article where it was mentioned that supply chain will generally constitute 60% of a operation, 60% value of the operation. So all of the companies if we are able to save 5% of our supply chain costs, we will save 3% in the total net worth value of what we are spending. So a result is always applicable if we are applying these type of strategies. I saw that in oil and gas market right now, current turmoil in the market, where precipitous fall in the prices of oil has forced many international companies to review their investment and risk assessment for 2015 and beyond. And the difficult time in oil and gas industry has created new demand and expectation for supply chain management. The fall in the prices does not mean that capital projects will not come or companies will start spending on the further investment on their capital projects. What they are doing is they are discussing with the EPC consultants how they can reduce the pricing. And supply chain, being a supply chain guy, I know that 60 to 70% of the spend of the capital project is through supply chain. So if we are able to, we can work on improving the supply chain and we can reduce 5% out of our supply chain, it can affect 3% of the overall cost of the company, of the project. So that's why companies are also showing keen interest in nowadays in supplier risk assessment and risk mitigation as well. What we are doing is we have centered our conversation on financial stress review of the supplier, because sometimes many of the suppliers fail to take orders which are big orders. Like we are placing an order for about 10 million. We need to think that either supplier financial risk assessment is done or not. Specific and important signals of supplier financial stability can be found and analyzed through its financial reports. So buying companies predict short run future financial condition of the supplier. Nowadays what we are doing is we are also using third party rating agencies which look forward for 90 days, debt load, credit score, and important flags in the financial stress review. So these type of strategies generally help different companies and different industries in different segments. And supply chain is being looking, the more all executives nowadays have their eyeballs focused on supply chain management.
And thanks, Ankit, for sharing today.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Dustin. Thank you very much for having me explaining the strategies for supply chain for superior results. It is something I am very passionate about. So if there is any questions, I am always available. You can, anybody can shoot me an email at ankitkullar.dcres@gmail.com or ankit.kullar@pro.com, and I will try to respond you as early as possible. Thanks, Dustin. Thanks.
Thank you.